Hi friends, this is Fani Bhushan Nagula. Today we're going to learn how to record test scripts and play using JMeter. So in JMeter, we have a proxy server which allows JMeter to track and record all the user actions or operations on the browser, or while the user is browsing the web application, it tracks all the user actions and it records the scripts automatically. So now let's understand how this feature is implemented and how we can use it to record the scripts. So we are using Apache 4th version, and earlier versions we used to have Workbench as default option here. So under Workbench, we used to add the record option. So now this feature from 4th onwards, it is there under the add non-test elements under HTTPS test script record. So you can directly add this under test plan now. So now, before we jump onto this screen, we need to set the HTTP proxy server. So let's go to our Chrome browser and go to settings. Scroll down. We have advanced here at the bottom. Click on advanced. Now again scroll down. We have open proxy settings. So here we need to set the proxy by clicking the LAN settings and click on the use proxy server for your LAN. So what we are going to do here is we have to mention local host, or you can mention 127.0.0.1 and port number 8080. And you just click on this, or you can just ignore it. And now click OK and click OK. So here you need to mention the same port number what you have given there, 8080. And if you are using under the test plan, if you are using anything, so the tar test plan creation where it has to store, like for example, if I am using like a thread group, then if you go back to your test script recorder and target controller, you can find this thread group. And under the thread group, if I'm using recording controller, and I can find the recording controller under the test plan thread group and recording controller. This is my target controller where the script should store. Do not group samplers. So if you are not using, if you want to use grouping method, you can use. So at present, let's keep it like this. Do not group samplers. Or if you want to use this, put each group in a new transaction controller. So we'll talk about what is meant by new transaction controller in our next session. So this grouping will help us to certain scenarios are under groups. So the grouping will automatically done by the JMeter. Now let's, instead of grouping it, just say do not group samplers and keep everything as it is. And here there are some HTTP sampler settings. I create new transaction after request, retrieve all embedded resources, and redirect automatically, use keep LM. So I'm just using everything default at present. Now let's go to, we have a start button. So when you're using start button, click. So let's understand what the difference it will show here. So when I clicked on the start button, which is used to intercept the browser request, if here, if you just again click allow access, and there is a pop-up here, root CA certificate, Apache JMeter temporary root CA. So it is creating a root CA certificate. So a file called Apache JMeter temporary root CA file will be created under JMeter bin directory. It will happen when you click on OK, but default it won't be there, and the certificate will be valid for 7 days. So this certification generation can take some time, but this cursor is, if you look at this, just click on OK and now go back to your performance testing JMeter and downloads, where your JMeter is there, and go to bin folder. Let's see. See here, Apache JMeter temporary root CA certificate is created under your bin folder. Now you means this will create a communication between your JMeter and all the browser, the actions which you are performing on the browser. Now let's go to the browser. I want to access www.naviltesting.com. So it's a little slow, but just meanwhile, just go back to JMeter and see what is happening. It's still not recording anything. Yeah. See here, it started recording it. So something is here. HTTP protocol, and it's access the server name. naviltesting.com, and there are a lot of other URLs here, CSS, JS. But let's go and click on one more thing, and under trainings, I want to click on performance testing using JMeter. So now again go back to your JMeter and go to your test script recorder, click stop. Now let's look at your script. So if you look at the script, we have done one is we have accessed the naviltesting.com, and then we clicked on our performance testing page. So there are two things happen now. So apart from these, we have JPG files, we have PNG files, we have WOFF files, PHP files. These are all are called embedded resources. So if you go back to your script recorder, retrieve all embedded resources, create new transaction after request. So it is, even though If you have not selected it, it retrieves whatever is available there. So now what should, now let's try to, you can delete which are not required for you for the moment, or you can disable it, and I'll delete it. So these are not required for me, and I know that these are files which are not required for my performance testing. I can delete it, and let me execute. Let me use this name also instead of one. I'll use the naveltesting.com only, and here instead of 60, let me remove this 69. Let me add, instead of recording controller, I can take, now I don't need any script recorder, and let me add listener view result string. I can take, I don't need this recording control anymore, and also I don't need this script recorder. So we are on proxy now. We need to come back and connect to our LAN. So again, you have to go back and go to settings, advanced, open proxy settings, click on LAN, use automatically detect settings, and disable this, or deselect use proxy server, deselect it, and click OK. Okay, then now you can go back and click here, record and playback example. So now let me click on the start or execute your script now. So I'm just using one normal thread group and one user. We'll go back to your results, naveltesting.com. Yeah, response code is 200 and response message is okay. So we have successfully recorded the script and executed. So if you go to your request, so this is your request get method, using get method. So we have called naveltesting.com, and this is the response data in HTML format. This is text format. If you want to look at your HTML, there are three different. So we have HTML, source format, and download resources. If you click on download resources, it will be exactly similar to your HTML page. See here, it will be like HTML page. So all these images you can see here, whatever you have on the website. So usually we use text format or JSON format for JSON pages. So now even if you go to performance testing, so the response is 200 and message is okay. So this is one of the method to record and playback the scripts. So sometimes your JMeter may not be effective in recording every action. So, and another method is we have, let's go to apps, or let me go to settings. Extensions, and let me check for Blaze Meter. Sorry, it is not available here. I did not add this. Let me Blaze Meter Chrome extension. So in the first results itself, you can find Blaze Meter. So this is the add-on available. Blaze Meter is the add-on available on Chrome. So let's understand. If you, so it will help you to record the scripts. Chrome extension records all of HTTPS requests and actual user interactions that your browser sends, creates a synced JMeter and Selenium scripts, and automatically uploads it to PlaceMeter. So it will help you to record even JMeter and also Selenium scripts. So let's go and install this add-on. I'm adding it to the Chrome. Now add the extension now. Still checking. Okay, now you can see the PlaceMeter icon is on the right top corner. Now let's close everything. I want only, I want to access only the application. So if you go to PlaceMeter, click on this PlaceMeter icon, it will ask you for login. So let's go. So I already have my login here. Let me log into this. Or you can use your Google credentials to log in. Click sign in. So once you are logged in, again go back to your browser and click. See here, we have logged in. And you can enter the name of the test. I'm saying this is www.naveltesting.com. This is my testing name, test name. And you have a button or icon to start the recording. Again, and you can use for JMeter and also Selenium. So this is very good option. So it is one PlaceMeter add-on is helping us to record the scripts and which will be useful for either JMeter or a Selenium. So let me record this now first. Start recording. I'm going and again using naveltesting.com. See here, as we have started accessing the application, your PlaceMeter started showing the scripts which is adding to the PlaceMeter. It started recording the scripts now. Now let me go to say performance testing. Testing under testing services, I'm clicking on performance testing services. Now it should increment now. See here now, earlier it was 2, now it is 3. It means that there's one more script added to the PlaceMeter. Now again go and add, let me add agile testing. So now it is 4. So now if you want to stop the recording or pause the recording, you can click either on the pause recording or stop recording. Let's stop recording. So you stop the recording. Now it has to generate the script now. So to generate the script now, again, what we have to do is we have an option to download the recording. So whatever it has been recorded, so you can download the recordings in, when you click on this link, so this icon, download icon, it is asking you for select the scripts to save. Either you want to save it for Taras, or you want to save it for Selenium, or you want to save it for JMeter. I want to, at present, because we are going through the JMeter sessions, we are interested to record the scripts for JMeter. Select this JMeter. Select domains to include in your scripts. If any other domain is included, you can exclude it. So by selecting the which domain needs to be selected as part of your recordings. So save now. it is started exporting to JMX format, our Java JMeter script. So it's downloading. Let's go to your downloads. See, we have naval testing.com. Let me copy this to our folder. Go to scripts and paste it here. Go to your JMeter. Now I am interested to open this file. Where is our naval testing? Yeah, naval testing.com. So let's see. So it's very intelligent. See here, it has added J header manager, user defined variables, request defaults. We will learn about all these configuration elements in the next session. So, but it's very intelligent, and this recording captured all the elements which are required. So authorization manager, cookie manager, cache manager. So these are coming default. Now under your script, recorded scripts, you have naval testing.com, and there is one thing called p something. Second script is something which is going to PHP. It may not be required. Let's disable this. It is not required for us. And we have clicked on the performance testing HTML, and we clicked on the agile testing HTML. We just need to add a listener to this. Go to listeners and just save it and Control R. Execute it now. So the one active thread, only we are using one thread, and now it should go and execute it. Now see here, the first naval testing.com, yeah, response code 200 and response message okay. It means it's passed. So these are all embedded resources. See, these many embedded resources. So we should deselect that option. So I'll tell you how to avoid these things. And let's go back to our result stream, whether it executed the performance testing .htm also. So it is also passed now. So you can see the response data. So you can see, as part of the sampler results in the view results tree, let's understand. So you have a thread name. So the thread name what you're given is thread group 1-1, and this your start time of the execution, load time, it took around 3231 milliseconds, and it took 264 milliseconds to connect, and your latency is fixed 569 milliseconds, and your size in bytes is, this is your the total response size, and this is the request which sent to the server, and headers size and the body size, the response body size. And this we have, because we have injected only one thread and the only one sample has been generated, that is the reason the count is 1. There are no errors and the data type is text only. So response code is 200 and response message okay. If the response is successful, it will give you 200 code, and these are the response headers. You also can see the request which contains, this is the get method and this is the URL. So these are request headers as part of your request, and as part of this request you can see you have connection, upgrade, insecure, accept, referral. But the major thing which you need to understand is user agent. We will go through this browser simulation. As part of the browser simulation, we will understand what is user agent. And now the accept language, which is English US, and accept encoding, which is gzip and dflate, and host is naval testing.com. So this is your request and this is the response in a text format. So this is the response in text format. So we will also understand in the next sessions, we'll understand how to validate. So our response data to say that no, this is the correct response whether we got it or not. So the Blaze Meter add-on is one of the add-on which is available to record the user transactions or the operations on the web application. And again, you can generate those recorded script to .jmx file, which will be opened in JMeter, and you can play it directly. So there might be, if you're, because I just used only the static website, so I don't need any correlation method here. But if you're using a dynamic site, then we need to look at the correlations. But those things we will learn in our next lesson. So this is about recording playback. So we have learned two concepts. One is recording through the JMeter option, which is when you click on test plan and go to non-test elements, we have HTTPS test script recorder. And the second option what we have used is Blaze Meter add-on. So thanks for watching the session.